Greetings, Sister Aya. The message of the gospel is not only for the men of Islam to hear. God's forgiveness is for women as well. Thank you for your great question. Such serious thoughts must be considered, well, seriously. Allow me to repeat your question and then answer it more fully than my short message. I am a girl, so call me sister. For me, I was born Muslim, but I have a brain to use. Whatever makes sense, I will take. But if I end up not believing in Islam, then other religions are not any better. How can you prove that the Bible is God's word? So your basic question is, how can I prove to you that the Bible is the word of God? I will do my best, sister, to give you the most succinct, that means short and clear, answer. Here is the answer I replied, but I am adding more details, including more scriptures from the Holy Bible. Well, greetings, sister. First, let me encourage you to continue using the mind which the Lord of Heaven has given you. He has no fear of questions, and he never criticizes someone for asking for knowledge. In fact, God, by the prophet Hosea, said the exact opposite. He said in Hosea 4:6, "My people are destroyed for lack of knowledge. Because you have rejected knowledge, I will also reject thee, that you shall not be a priest to me. Seeing thou hast forgotten the law of thy God, I will also forget your children." I want to repeat, sister, God's message in the Bible is that he wants you to think and to seek knowledge. Proverbs 18:15, "The heart of the prudent gets knowledge, and the ear of the wise seeks knowledge." Proverbs 4:7, "Wisdom is the principal thing, therefore get wisdom, and with all thy getting, get understanding." 1 Samuel 2:3, "Talk no more so exceedingly proudly, let not arrogance come out of your mouth, for the Lord is a God of knowledge, and by him actions are weighed." And there is one other example I want to give you, sister, of God rewarding the pursuit or the request for knowledge. 2 Chronicles 1:9. "Now, O Lord God, let your promise upon David my father be established, for you have made me king over a people like the dust of the earth in multitude. Give me now wisdom and knowledge, that I may go out and come in before this people. For who can judge this thy people that is so great?" And God said to Solomon, "Because this was in thine heart, and thou hast not asked for riches, wealth, or honor, nor the life of your enemies, neither yet have you asked for long life, but has asked for wisdom and knowledge for yourself, that you may judge my people over whom I have made you king, wisdom and knowledge is granted unto you, and I will give you riches and wealth and honor, such as none of the kings have had that have been before thee, neither shall there any after thee have the like." So, Aya, I want you to be aware that the God of the Torah and Bible wants you to seek knowledge and wisdom. So never be afraid to ask and always seek God's knowledge. The proof that the Bible is God's word has been provided by God himself, sister. It is called the more sure word of prophecy. 2 Peter 1:19. "We have also a more sure word of prophecy, whereunto you do well that you take heed, as unto a light that shines in a dark place." And think about it, because the future is a dark place. We can't see it. "Until the day dawn and the day star arises in your hearts." God lives outside the limit of time. And only God may know the future before it happens. He reveals the end of things even before they have begun. Isaiah 46:10, I make known the end from the beginning, from ancient times what is still to come. I say, my purpose will stand, and I will do all that I please. Now, sister, you will have to face one thing in listening to this video. You will have to face the claim by Islam that the Bible has been corrupted. You are asking for proof that the Bible is the Word of God. But if you already assume it is changed and corrupted, any and all proof is meaningless. When you judge the Quran, you judge it by the Quran, meaning by what the Quran says about itself. If you are honestly to judge the Bible, you must judge the Bible by what it says about itself. You must not judge the Bible by what Islam says about it. I hope that makes perfect sense. Continuing my text reply, in fact, God has revealed through the prophets the future events that prove He exists and that He is the Lord of time itself. The proof is in the many details which God and His prophets revealed about the Messiah before the Messiah came. I will list just a handful here. Now I want to detail specifically what I mean by prophecy. God sent the prophets, sister, to give details that would act as signs. Imagine I tell you, sister, that I will send a friend to talk to you and give you details describing him. He is 6 feet tall, has black hair, a mustache, speaks fluent Hebrew, reads Arabic, and walks with a limp. Now, if a 6 foot tall man with black hair and a mustache met you, speaking fluent Hebrew and walking with a limp, you would only need give him Arabic text to read, and he would prove that he fit the description of the man I described. This is how God both identified the Messiah and God proved His participation in the message of the prophets. God would give details of the future to the prophets to speak and reveal to the Hebrew people. If a man came claiming to speak for God, and what he said did not come to pass, he was to be killed. Deuteronomy 18:20, but the prophet who presumes to speak a word in my name that I have not commanded him to speak, or who speaks in the name of other gods, that same prophet shall die. As an aside, this is why Muhammad could never go to Israel. Had Muhammad gone to Israel in the name of another god, Allah, they would have killed him. Something to think about. When God fulfills the words of the prophet, God proved that He sent the prophet with the message. For example, let's look at Prophet Samuel. 1 Samuel 3:19. The Lord was with Samuel as he grew up, and he, the Lord, let none of his or Samuel's words fall to the ground. And all Israel from Dan to Beersheba recognized that Samuel was attested as a prophet of the Lord. To attest is to testify and verify. The proof is in the many details which God and His prophets revealed about the Messiah before the Messiah came. I will list just a handful here. 1. The Messiah would be born of a virgin. The detail of the virgin birth is first given by Prophet Isaiah, sister. Then this is confirmed that this was fulfilled in the New Testament. That is a pattern which God has repeated over and over, Aya. For 3,000 years, Yahweh sent prophets who delivered prophetic details by which men could recognize Messiah, the Son of God. 2. The Messiah would be born in Bethlehem. 3. God would call His Son out of Egypt. 4. The Messiah would have His hands and feet pierced. The Messiah would be sold out for 30 pieces of silver. The payment would be given to a potter. The Messiah would be counted among the transgressors. Ezekiel prophesied that Yahweh himself would be pierced. Messiah would be cut off or killed, but not for himself. Messiah would be wounded for our transgressions, bruised for our iniquities. In the Old Testament, sister, there are over 100 prophecies about the Messiah. I have heard some claim a count as high as 300. But I would rather be conservative and have facts which are less tenuous. The sum and total of the prophetic events about Messiah are a logical proof, Aya, because of several things. First, they were all told before the events surrounding the Messiah happened. We know this for an absolute and unquestionable fact because the Hebrews translated the Hebrew Torah into Greek at least 100 years before Jesus the Messiah was born. No man could predict all these things, and the possibility of them happening randomly is mathematically impossible. Second, the details of the prophecies could not have been orchestrated or created by men. And faked fulfillment or orchestration must be considered before hand-waving and ruling it out. We must consider the possibility of one man controlling and delivering and then fulfilling such a message. The Torah was delivered by many dozens of men over a time span of 3,000 years. Contrast that with one man over 23 years creating the Quran. Which situation offers the opportunity for possible fraud by one man? We must consider the possibility of a group of men controlling and delivering and then fulfilling such a message. It is possible that many men can cooperate to write a work over many generations. Historians do this very thing, yet no one worships their writings as holy or from God, do they? The Torah is special because it records the acts of God, miracles, and prophecies. And the prophecies, the detailing of future knowledge, is what sets the Torah and Bible apart from every book considered holy. Because there are events which no group of men could ever orchestrate. And while this too is an irrefutable aspect of the proof, I will not detail it beyond this. Ezekiel 37:3, "And he said unto me, Son of man, can these bones live? And I answered, O Lord God, you know. And again he said unto me, Prophesy unto these bones, and say unto them, O you dry bones, hear the word of the Lord. Thus saith the Lord God unto these bones, Behold, I will cause breath to enter into you, and you shall live." And on the same topic, prophet Isaiah revealed the following. "Who has ever heard of such a thing, and whoever sees such things? Can a country be born in a single day, or can a nation be brought forth in a single moment? Yet no sooner was Zion in labor than she delivered her children." The single greatest miracle and fulfillment of prophecy so far in our lifetimes, that Israel is a nation in the earth. Continuing with the message, I replied, "While Jesus might be able to control some details, such as intentionally committing an act which would get him crucified, he could not control his virgin mother, or the town of his birth, or his parents escaping to Egypt. Even on the cross, Jesus could not control the many fulfillments at that time. The soldiers would gamble or cast lots for his garment. His side would be pierced. Not one bone would be broken. These are just a few of the prophecies fulfilled, all of which you can find in the original, given in the Old Testament, and then the fulfillment in the New Testament. You see, Aya, God is thorough and completely able to preserve his word. and the very reason Satan needs to claim the Torah and Bible are corrupted. I have several videos I ask you to please watch about the more sure word of prophecy. The following are my two videos on the topic: The More Sure Word of Prophecy Part 1 and The More Sure Word of Prophecy Part 2. In this first video, I mention another video I recently watched, which I wholeheartedly recommend for the thoroughness of handling the math involved in the probability of prophetic predictions. Subsequently, this video appears to have been removed. The teacher's name is Chuck Missler. His technical knowledge is superb and his research is thorough. Please ask any additional questions under those videos after you have had a chance to watch them all the way through. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.